हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस स्टडी अबाउट द पॉलीजेनिक इनहेरिटेंस। व्हेन टू और मोर जीन्स एडिटिवली डिसाइड्स द सिंगल फेनोटाइप, सच टाइप ऑफ जीन्स आर कॉल्ड एज द पॉलीजीन्स एंड देयर इनहेरिटेंस इज कॉल्ड एज द पॉलीजेनिक इनहेरिटेंस। सो द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द पॉलीजेनिक इनहेरिटेंस, वी कैन कंसिडर फर्स्ट द व्हीट कर्नेल कलर। व्हीट कर्नेल color. So the polygenic inheritance was first studied by the scientist Nilsson Ehle. Nilsson and Ehle, these scientists studied the polygenic inheritance on the wheat kernel color. So the cover of the wheat can be of the two colors. One is the red and another is white. Red color is dominant over the white color, and the red color is decided by the two types of the genes. One is dominant A and another is dominant B. So when the genes are AA and BB, so AA, these are the alleles of each other, and BB are alleles of each other. So these two genes A and B, they are deciding the red color, red wheat kernel color, right? And the recessive gene are a, b, these decides the white kernel color. So here the two genes A and B, they decide the wheat kernel color. If one pure line dominant is crossed with the pure line recessive, then the offspring produced are capital A, small a, capital B, small b, because these will produce the AB gametes and these will produce small a, small b gametes, right? So when these gametes will fuse together, they will form the F1 offspring, and this F1 offspring will have the kernel color that is intermediate in between the red and white. Here the wheat kernel color is intermediate between the red and the white. If all the genes are dominant, then the red color is produced. So if all the four genes are dominant, here you can see, if all the four genes are dominant, then the red color is produced, right? If instead of four, if the three are the dominant genes, then the color produced will be the medium red, or it will be called as less red, right? So it will be a medium red color, right? So this will be the dark red. First color we can consider it as the dark red. Second color, if the three genes are dominant, then the color is the medium red. If the two genes are recessive, then the color will be the intermediate. It will be the intermediate red color, right? So intermediate between the red and white. Then if the one gene is dominant and the three genes are recessive, then the color produced will be light, right? So color will be the light. And if the zero gene is dominant and all genes are recessive, then the color will be white. So here the wheat kernel color is decided by the number of the dominants and the number of recessive genes. If the all the genes are dominant, then the color produced is the dark red, right? If one gene is recessive, then medium red color will be produced. If the two genes are dominant and two genes are recessive, then the intermediate color will be produced. If the one gene is dominant and other three are recessive, then the light color will be produced. And if all the genes are recessive, then the white color is produced. So here this intermediate color is produced by the F1 offspring, right? So this F1 offspring is producing the intermediate color. If this F1 offspring is self-crossed. If AABB is crossed with the AABB, means it is self-crossed, right? So when AABB is self-crossed, this AABB will produce the four types of gametes. It will produce the four types of gametes. So these four types of gametes are capital A, capital B. This will be the first gamete, capital A, capital B. Second will be capital A, small b. Third will be small a, capital B. And fourth will be small a, small b. So these are the four types of gametes produced by the F1, right? So when these four types of gametes are crossed with the another four types of gametes produced by the male and female, right? So the offspring produced will be 16, means 16 combinations can be obtained when we cross these four gametes, right? So here we can write it, one is male, another is female. Here we can write capital A, capital B, capital A, small b, small a, capital B, small a, small b, right? So same we can write here, A, B, A, small b, small a, capital B, and small a, small b, right? So here the offspring produced are, here you can see A, A, B, B. Here all the four genes will be dominant. So instead of writing all the gametes, I will write only the number of the dominant, right? So here AABB, four dominant will be produced. Here capital A, capital A, capital B, small b, three dominant genes will be produced, right? Capital A, small a, capital B, capital B. Here also three dominant genes will be produced. Here two dominant genes will be produced. Here 1, 2, 3, three dominant genes will be produced. 1, 2, two dominant genes will be produced here. 1, 2, two dominant genes will be produced here. Here one dominant gene will be produced, right? Here in this case 2 and 3, three dominant will be produced. Here the two dominant will be produced. Here the two dominant will be produced. Here one dominant will be produced. Here two dominant. Here one dominant. Again one dominant, and here zero dominant, right? So in this way we have made a cross, and in this cross we have checked how many dominant genes are there, right? So first let us observe how many maximum dominant genes are present. Maximum dominant genes present are 4, and only one offspring out of 16 have the four dominant genes. Means all four dominant genes are present in only one offspring. So that is 1. We will write it here. All the four dominant genes are present in the darkest red, right? Then medium red. Medium red will have the three dominant genes. So how many of offspring have the three dominant genes? 1, 2, then 3, and this is 4, right? So the four offsprings have the three dominant genes. So here four offspring have the three dominant gene are present. So these will be the medium red, or these are also called as medium dark red. Then how many offspring are having the two dominant genes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Six offsprings are having the two dominant genes. Two dominant genes means they are intermediate. So only these are six offsprings, right? Who are having the two dominant genes. Now, this one dominant gene is present in 1, 2, 3, 4 offsprings. So the four offsprings have one dominant gene, and one dominant gene is present in the light colored seed, right? So it is one dominant gene is present in the four offsprings, right? Now the zero dominant gene is present in only one, right? So here I will write again, the white colored seed is produced by the one offspring. So here the ratio obtained is 1 is to 4 is to 6 is to 4 is to 1. Right. So here the five types of offsprings are produced. Right. So first is the darkest red, that is only 1. Medium red are 4. Intermediate are 6. Light colored are 4 and white colored is 1. So the ratio obtained here is 1 is to 4 is to 6 is to 4 is to 1. Right. So if the offspring produced is a dihybrid, then the ratio obtained in the polygenic inheritance is 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. That is 1 is to 4 is to 6 is to 4 is to 1. So this is the polygenic inheritance about the wheat kernel color. This polygenic inheritance is also observed in case of the human skin color. Various characteristics which shows the gradations, like the human skin color, you can find the gradations in the human skin color. In the same way, in the wheat kernel color, you will find the gradations. You will find the darkest red color, you will find the intermediate, you will find the white color, you will find the light color, as well as the medium red color. In the height of the person also, you can find the persons who are having the different height, right? So whenever the gradations are generally observed, these gradations denote about the polygenes. So when more than one gene is present in an individual, and the cumulative or the additive effect of this more than one gene results in a single type of phenotype, these are called as the polygenes, and the effect of polygenes is the additive of all the types of the genes, right? So all the types of polygenes, they show their final effect depending upon their dominant as well as the recessive genes, number of dominant and number of recessive genes.